Okay, so today's subject is about AKI. AKI stands for acute kidney injury. Long time ago, we used to call it acute kidney insufficiency, but we no longer use this term anymore. If you see someone writing acute kidney insufficiency in one of the notes on a patient, you gotta know this doctor hasn't been reading for a while. AKI is divided into pre-renal, intrarenal, and post-renal. A lot of students have trouble figuring out which is which and how do I differentiate. Let me start with the easier part. Post-renal is basically kidney injury because there is some problem in the outflow. So, if someone has a kidney and ureter and there's a big stone over here, this will cause backflow of urine, all right, to the kidneys, and that is not good for the kidneys. That's basically it. If someone has a big old prostate and that prostate is not letting the ureters empty into the bladder, then you're gonna get the same problem. If you wanna bet, whenever a patient comes into the hospital that he has post-renal AKI, this is probably the least common of all of those. And usually the patient will tell you, oh, I've been having trouble peeing for a long while, I haven't been taking my prostate medications, or he would tell you, I've been having a lot of kidney stones lately, and I see some kind of sand coming out of my urine. That's it. That was easy. Now, what is the difference between pre-renal or intrarenal? Basically, pre-renal is acute kidney injury because there is no enough blood flow. So, basically, you're not feeding your kidney very well. This is the most common acute kidney injury if you are outpatient. So, basically, a patient comes in, he was working in the field, it was too sunny outside, and he hasn't been drinking water. Comes into the hospital and they find his creatinine has been 2 or 3, you can bet on it that this is pre-renal acute kidney injury. What are they going to do for this patient? Fluids. And that's it. Now, what about intra? This basically means that the patient has something wrong with his tubules, all right? Something has gone wrong. And this is where it gets very complicated and where you can find multiple causes for such entity. Always think about medications, toxins. In the medication part, remember NSAIDs, gentamicin, vancomycin. And that's why such antibiotics, we have blood tests that we have to measure the levels of those antibiotics. And guess why? Because they cause problems. Whenever you have a test for any medication, always remember that if this medication goes very high in the blood, it's going to cause a problem. In this case, it's going to cause renal acute kidney injury. Now, how do we figure out the difference between pre-renal and intrarenal? And sometimes it's not that easy, but for your exam purposes, remember that there's something called FINA. FINA stands for fractional excretion of sodium. If it's less than 1%, it means something, and if it's more than 2%, it means something else. If it's less than 1%, you're usually talking about a pre-renal cause. If it's more than 2%, you're talking about renal pathology. If it's in between, I'm not really sure. But sometimes it's very difficult to remember those numbers, but let me tell you something. If you are a patient who is dehydrated, your kidneys are gonna try to get back all the sodium back to the blood. Because once you get all the sodium back, Eventually, all the fluids will be back. You're trying to keep every single drop of water in your blood. So if you measure the fractional excretion of sodium, your sodium in urine will be low. Urine sodium will be low. And that will eventually lead to less than 1% fractional excretion of sodium. This is definitely just the easy version of it. Okay, but you literally have to calculate this using the formula. If someone has renal AKI or intrarenal AKI, basically there is something wrong with the tubules, to the fact that there is no control about how much sodium I'm losing in the urine. And this is why their urine sodium will be high. And if you calculate the FeNA using the equation, you'll find that the FeNA is high. Now, always remember that if someone is on diuretics, you cannot use the FeNA. And why is that? Because when you use diuretics, you will be throwing more sodium in your urine, and this is how the diuretics work. So if someone is already on diuretics and they come in with AKI, you can say, I don't really know if it's pre-renal or intrarenal. And in this case, they will use something called phe-urea, which is basically the fractional excretion of urea. Thank you for watching this lecture.